Hello guys, today I'll be showing you how to play Build and Destroy. Today I'll be starting out with just some basic things that you would need to know to play this game. So here's the menu. This is what you'll see when you join the game. I'd recommend joining this group because it gives you 45 free slave slots. It's really helpful. And this is just the update logs, you know, you can read that if you want. That's its channel, and then this is the play now button. So this is where you'll be when you join. This is your garage, this is where you build stuff. So, this little panel here, labeled garage, it opens your doors, you see? You have a roof, a back door, a front door, and then a visitor door, just in case you don't want people with large builds to be coming in. Because if I close my door, right, and then I go up here, if I had a big build and I tried to get in here, it wouldn't work, but I could visit with my player model. So we'll open that back up, because I like to have the, views, you could say. And then, this is our part controls, and you can clean your own parts, or you can clean others' parts, so if somebody brings a thing in here and you don't like it, you can just click others and yes, it'll clear their parts. And then this is just a shortcut for this button. So we'll have settings. This is your quick bar, which if you hit that, you can have all this stuff here, you know. So pretty good for finding stuff quicker. You can see that you have to clear my parts, clear other parts, hit markers on. So if you shoot something, you'll get a hit marker, and you can turn that off or on. This is your grid base plate thing. This is just the little grid over here, and then the grid material on. Basically, what that is you see how this is like a looks like. Floor. You can turn that on or off. I'll show you how that looks with the build. So basically this is the Jeep with it, and then if I turn it off, that's what it looks like without it. So I'll delete this. And then this is what you can do with your door. Also, you can make glass like this. You can see through it, but people still can't come in. That's just your front door. Yeah, that's the rest of the doors. This is where you can purchase starter stuff, which you can if you want to, but you'd probably rather build something. But these right here are free. You see, you can get a starter robot. And functions like this. So if you wanna use this, right, you gotta hit this little red button down here. It's called battle mode. Let me click yes. Oh yes, I didn't mention. Press E to fly and then Q to run. You can run while you're flying too, you see? Getting slower and then faster. So that's a nice thing. So you get in your seat here. See that you can move stuff around. You can click Q to go a bit faster. But you see this, you can either hit 5 or you can click this little tool down here that says mech. And you see V for jump. So if you hold it, it makes you float a little bit. You can, these parts right here are, they destroy stuff. So you can walk up to somebody's build and you can whack it and it'll destroy stuff. And inside of here, if I can get there, you see these little red things? They are spikes. So basically they can kill people. So we're gonna walk up to this building here, which is, it's a building that anybody can destroy. You can test your stuff on it, you know, you can do anything. And then, this is the battlefield here. So you can just walk out here and do anything you want with your builds. And you don't have to be destroying people's builds. Like, you can build a car and just drive around if you want. But, we'll cut this tower. See? If I whack it, I'm getting those hit markers. Now, if I turn that off, see, I'm not getting those anymore. So I'm gonna just leave those on. So now I'm destroying the building here. You see, when I destroy something with these bumper and these TNT parts, they get removed. So, how that works is you can destroy one part with the bumper, but it deletes itself afterwards. So here's the building. I just cut it in half. Now it's gonna fall in the water, I think. Yeah. But TNT, the special thing with TNT is the bigger it is, the more damage it does. You saw how I was getting like 53 on that little hit marker there. That's because the TNT is hitting it. But the bigger you make your TNT, the more damage it does. And these little parts here are your stabilizers. So, whichever way this little cross thing here is facing is the way it will stabilize. They don't have infinite force, which means that they can still be bent around, but they'll try their best to, like, stay up like this. So, these are for your mech body. So, if you got out of the seat, which a mech seat already has a stabilizer inside of it, so you can, if you got out of your mech and turned those off, then it can fall over. I'll show you that. So, click those. Well, it's kind of hard to get it to fall over, but we'll try. It's pretty stable. But anyways, that would have fallen over if it was didn't have the correct weight and everything. So now we'll go back to the cloud and we'll load a starter car. So this is basically just a little thing you can drive around in. You can add stuff to it, like, let's say I wanted to go up to somebody, and I wanted to destroy their build, and I wanted to kill them too. So, I'll put a big TNT right here to destroy their build, and I'll put a few spikes. See? And now I can drive up to them, and I can destroy their build and kill them, because I have spikes and TNT. So I'm going to show you this on the tower. TNT this size will probably do about the same as the mech did. Maybe a little bit more. We're going to go up to the tower and hit it with our TNT. And it doesn't have the biggest blast radius, that's why it didn't do much damage there. But if you had a lot of parts in a small area, it would break all of them. And this is our vehicle seats, what allows us to drive a car, and these are our wheels. You see those little yellow hinges there? They have to be touching a block to be able to drive this. But yeah, that's how that works. I'll put a video on how to figure out how to make your car drive, maybe later. So, this is your shop. You see, you can buy game passes. These are annoying, I wouldn't recommend buying these. They're just little things that go on, like, the side of your character, and they're annoying, because you can't build with them. And then, you can already use this by clearing people's parts, but, like, it's kind of cool, because it makes it, like, slowly fade away, kind of like a, Thanos snap. And then, this is just a shortcut to the cloud, which we saw earlier, which is what I have the builds in, so. These are just, donations, you know. See, here, he donated, so he gets a yellow name. I'm just gonna tell him I'm making a video. He'll go away. So, Yeah, that's how that works. And then this is going to be coming out in version 1.8, and so will this. And this brings you to the menu, right? So this is what you see when you join. And then settings. You can click these little buttons here to make these go away, but I just keep them there. Because they don't really bother me. So if you hold Shift plus H, you can make your screen go away, and they can bring it back with the same key. And this little thing here shows you you're in your building zone. So if I walk out of my building zone, you can see you are not in your building zone. So you can't build outside of your building zone. This little blue marker here, well, it depends which garage you're in. You see, his is red because he's in garage 2. But this little blue marker here says that I can build in this zone. So this is your players list. The level is like how many hours somebody has played. So you get like a level every hour. And then it's obviously your chat there. So let's get on to the tools. So you see, if we have a part here, we can resize it. So we can make it bigger like this. I usually use plastic here. We press G and then plastic. And that'll make it this. And then K is your resize tool. So we can see how many studs the part is. So a stud is... this is a stud here. This is 1 by 1 by 1, as you can see. But what if you're building something like a car, and you want to have better precision? So you can change the increment here. You see, I set that to 0.5, and now it says it's 0.5 right here, because that's how big it is. And it gives you a bit more precision. So you can set that to 0.1. As you can see, a lot more precision than the other tool. See, 1.6. And we can make a really, really small part here, which is nice for building detailed things. And then we can set it to 0.05, which is half of 0.1, and that gives us even more leeway. But you can only make stuff at 0.05, and I'll show you how to do that. So this is collisions. We turn that on, and we can make it block really small like this. This is the smallest block you can make. So, there's issues with welding this to stuff. You'll probably figure that out if you try to weld it to something, it falls off. So, you just gotta have a bigger block. So, I'll copy another one. Make it plastic, because I like that. It helps me see two studs, because every one of these little cross marks is two studs. If I were to resize this, you can see that's a different block there. You can see that this is a block and this is a block. But if I had it as smooth plastic here, you can see that it doesn't work very well. So how I'm selecting like this, you see, I'm dragging this block over. So I'm holding my left shift, and then I'm clicking with my left click. And you can drag a box over something and it will select it all, just like that. And then we see this one last button here. So both, you see, that makes it resize in both directions. So if we had this part up here and we selected both, you see that it's moving in both directions. If you selected normal, it's just gonna move in the direction you're pulling it towards. So there's how that works. So we have a painting tool, right? So this is all the paint colors. You can click on a color you want. It will show you what color name that is. You can paint it. So I want a red block here and a green block there. You can see you can do that. And then you can also select stuff like this and paint it all by selecting a color. But you can also go into this advanced paint button up here, and you can make a really nice color. Like, I say, well, I want a slightly lighter pink. but I also want it to be more dull, you know? It's like a pastel pink. You can do that with this. So let's remove those parts. This right here, this is how you'd add a surface on something. I'll explain what a surface is. So you can see that you can select normal here, and you can see that I can put one of these on right, left, back, front, bottom, top, or all. So what all would do right here, if I wanted to put a motor on this, you see it selects all sides to put a motor on it. So that's how that works. We can put all welds on it. We can put all universal. So how universal works, it's kind of like a Lego. You see how this has inlets and it's just gonna stick in the outlet there. So these would stick together. So if we said this is, if we select classic here and we select inlets and then inlets, and we go into battle mode, you can see these two parts. What? How did that stick together? Okay, I don't know how that works, but okay. Like, there we go. Hold on, let me try that again. That wasn't supposed to happen. I don't know why that happened. So we're gonna go to all, and then we're gonna select universal. And then we can only see these textures if we are selecting plastic. So we can say like brick or corroded metal, or we have like metal. But if we select plastic, you can see that we can see the surfaces on there. And hinges and motors are the only surfaces you can see that are with another texture. So if we made this like corroded metal again, and then we put a hinge here and a motor here, you can see that we can see that. But if I made this plastic, you can see that we couldn't see this little universal pattern here. So let's put inlets on inlets, because I don't know why that stuck together. It wasn't supposed to stick together. Yeah, I'm not sure. I guess it's broken. I haven't tested that in a while anyways. But anyways, we have our two parts here. We'll select all weld, and then we'll make it plastic. And then you can see classic. Basically, you can select no outline or smooth, which are basically the same thing, because back in old Roblox, you might have played an old Roblox game and seen that some of the parts have that little gray outline around the block. That is because that's just how it used to be, and no outline would make it have no outline, but we don't have that anymore, so it doesn't really matter. It just smooths the part, which means if we smooth it, these two parts will not stick together. You see, if I select classic and then smooth, I can smooth these parts here. They are not gonna go anywhere, or they're not gonna weld together, because you can see. Here, I'll just make it transparency 0.5. You can see that there is no plastic in there. You can't see the little X, so that means that they're not gonna weld together. You see, if I what? Okay, I think that's a glitch. I don't quite know what's happening there. I honestly don't know what's happening. But anyways, when that's fixed, those two surfaces would not stick together. But we can also use a hinge, which is a way to turn something. I'm going to grab an anchor part here, which means that this part here, it's basically like if you're in building mode, you see that your parts won't fall, but if you go into battle mode, they will. This will prevent it from falling. So if we put a block on a hinge here, you see, and then we make it like transparency 0.5, you can see that that little thing rotates on there. So it's basically a spinning. So a motor, it actually isn't a motor. It's a motor hinge is what I would say. It's basically like if I put a motor on here, it's gonna have more resistance, 'cause you know how you spin like a normal thing, and then you have a motor. Motors are kind of harder to spin. So I'll put an anchor on there. And you see that it has a bit of resistance to it. If this block was heavier, it would actually move around on there, but it's not heavy enough to counter the force of the motor. But anyways, that's how a motor is. So go back into building mode. You always want to be in building mode when you're building. Which, if I go into battle mode, I try to do this. See, can't use this tool in battle mode. It's because you can't really build with that. grab this block here, plastic, and then select classic. So inlet studs, weld universal hinge motor at no outline. You can kind of see what that does. So now we're gonna be focusing on this tool, which you saw me use earlier a bit. So this is how you can select material. So I want this part to be glass, right? So you can see that, hey, wait a minute, I can't see through it. So that's weird. So you have to actually set the reflectance of something. So I can set this to 1. Oh wait, that's not. Hold on, I messed up on that. I meant the transparency, I'm sorry. So you can set that to 1, right? And then you can see that, hey, I can see through it. But Zen didn't want people to make fully invisible blocks because that can be abused in the game. So there's a max transparency, which is 0.8. But you can set it to like ridiculous numbers like that. Never mind, you can't. You can set it to something like that. You can see. It's really hard to see through it. I'll take the reflectance off, and you can see that you can see this through this block. So, yeah. And then I want this block to be diamond plate, so yeah, you can see it becomes diamond plate. You can make it transparent. Now, on to reflectance. Reflectance basically reflects the skybox, so you can see that there's a cloud on there, you know, because it's coming off of the skybox. Kind of looks like I'm looking through your window right there, but that's not how it works. It just reflects the skybox onto this block. So, you can only see that with smooth plastic, or glass. See, if I set it to metal here, you can see the reflectance goes away. So, if I get another block here, the collision basically means that, so I can walk through this, right? And then I can walk through it. So yeah, that's how that works. Now if I go into battle mode, it just falls to the ground like that, you see, because it doesn't attach to anything. So you can use that for like, you can make a door out of it, like you can build a house and you can make the door non-collide and you can walk through it. And that's how that would be. So we have this next tool here. I'll just grab a thruster from the part count there. So you can see it has a lot of thrust. So that's a lot of thrust. You can see that we have a million thrust. So I'll set it to like 100. That makes it not work as fast. So our thruster, I'll set it up right next to a thruster with stock thrust, which is faster than this one. So you can see that this thruster, it doesn't even move that much because it doesn't have enough thrust to even move itself. So you can edit the properties of part, like you can have a hover part to like 50, or you can have one to 100, Keep in mind that you can turn these on and off too. So what a hover part does is it just hovers at the specific height you set it at. So this is 100 on the vector 3, you know. So there's that. And then we have this, which is our resize tool. I already showed you that. So this is our copy part, which is the second tool. You can copy anything from these part stands. You can copy blocks like this. If you hold click, you can drag. You see how I'm dragging those? So that's how that would work. This is your part stand. You can get all your parts from here, but you can also get it from insert. I'll show you that very later. This is insert. So move, if I were to grab a part here, like this, and I can move it, you see? But just like the resize tool, we can have an increment. So I'm going to set that to 0.1. You can see that that moves a bit more precision, right? So that's your move tool. So we have this sphere here. And I was building something like a doorway, right? And then I let's move this over here. So I was gonna use this as my door, but I realized it was a spear and I can't really use a spear for a door, so I'll get rid of it. You can also see that you can drag a box over something, delete it, and then Shift Z and Shift Y are what make it come back and go back away. So if you delete something on accident, you can hit this button or you can press Shift Z and it makes all the stuff come back. You see that? All the stuff is back. So that's how that works. And then this is your mech tool. So I'm just going to build a little example for this. I'm going to make a sled here, so I want to drive around on a sled. This is how this would work. So we have a thruster here, actually I'll put it in the center, and we want it to be centered, so we're going to hit 0.5 on our increment because that's half of 0.1, you see now it's centered. So this will be our steering. This little hinge here is which way the thruster is thrusting towards. So, this will push this block this way, push it this way. Actually, we'll put these up here. These will be our steering thrusters. So, we're going to set that to 5,000 5,000 and then 10,000. And this is our driver's seat. This is what you can build a car with, but also it has a speedometer, you see. We're going zero speed right now, but it counts speed, how fast this is going. So if we moved one stud, which is this, if we moved this far in 1 second, it would just say one on the speed dial. But if we move this far in that many seconds, you see it's moved 16 studs. I forgot to mention that. You can see how far you're moving something, but it resets once you stop clicking on it and you re-click on it. So that's helpful. But anyways, it counts how many studs you're moving per second. So we'll go into edit here. See, this is your control panel. You can see if we did have keybinds here, they'd be showing up here. So if we hit edit and then we click a block we want to keybind, you see, we can only click blocks like this. So, there are the blocks you can select. All of these can be keybinded. Most of these can be keybinded. Actually, no, all of them can. So, we'll put a camera on the front, right? So we want to look where we're going. Like, for some reason, we want a camera on the front. I'll just say that. So we're gonna find a key that we want, and I'd recommend not using Q and E because that is your run and your fly, but you can also change that in this game settings. So if I set Q on here, and I went in the game settings, and I just set my E or my run to R, then that would work. But I'm gonna keep it as Q. So Yeah, if we set this to Q here and normal, which means if we click on it normally, if we just hit Q, then the camera would show up, okay? And you can set your name, I usually don't, but I'll show you how to do that. So this when we press it is gonna push us this way. So we're gonna set this to D, hold opposite, which means hold normal, basically. I'll explain this. So if you're holding a key, it makes the block hold until you stop holding the key. So turn on as long as you hold the block or the key, I meant. So if we select hold opposite, that means that if I'm holding a key, it turns off when I'm not holding it anymore. So we'll select hold opposite and we'll say this is steer right, you know? Oops. This is steer right. Okay, so we can control key. No, never mind. Sorry. If you hit control, you can see when I hold D, it turns it red because I'm using that key right now. And it's turning on this thruster. You see, if I hit Q, this is our camera. And I'll show you something cool you can do with a camera. So, if you see here, you can see field of view. You might be like, okay, so what does that do? So, that's basically like zooming in. You can see, turn off the camera here. This is set to 70 as default, but we can set it to 120. See, that's max. Field of view on right click, that means if you hit your right mouse button, that means that it's going to be 50 field of view, right? So this is 120 FOV. Looks kind of weird, doesn't it? So this is 50 and then this is 15. I'm clicking right click to do that. So that's how that works. I'm just delete the camera because we don't need it. I just wanted to show you that. So we'll set A, hold opposite, and then we'll say steer left, okay? And then we just gotta hit the key really quick, and that'll reset it. See? Because it was already on, but now it's off. So now we'll hit W, and then hold opposite, and we'll say this is go forwards. Right? So we can remember that W is go forwards, A is steer left, D is steer right, you know? So, how to save this, right? So we'll just say, set a test, not one, we'll say it's a thruster sled. So this is our thruster sled here. You can see I hit save, and then I click yes. It has a cooldown, so you see. Please wait 4 seconds before you can save it. But it's saved in there. I already saved it. So anyways, you can see that hitting W can make us go fast, and this is how fast we're going. So you can see that that's our steering. It's a bit fast for steering, so you might want to set that like a little bit lower, but you can move around like this, right? So I'll go back to our garage. So that's how this little J tool works here. So, or what you can use it for. So, or our Mac tool, I meant. So I'll be right back. And now we can see we were going to use the insert tool, and we have a cylinder. You see, this is basically what we're selecting, so that's just the categories of stuff. We can insert a part. It's basically the same thing as copying something. But the thing is, you know, you can have a cylinder here and a cylinder there, but the thing about the insert tool is that when Zen was making this game, he didn't think that we were gonna have so many parts, so he only built 8 part stands, right? So if we go to the insert tool, you see we have parts that we can't find on the parts stand, right? So if we go here, you can't find that fire. So this is where you can find extra parts, like booster, which is basically like a thruster, but I'll show you what it does. So the only way we'll be able to, actually we can't click it, so we'll just set it to F, normal, confirm key bind, right, and then you can see if we hit F, right, it shoots it, so it's basically like a thruster, but it deletes itself after it forces a block, so. Yeah, you can find stuff. This is a suit builder, you know. We'll get onto this later. It builds suits and it connects it to your body. So you can build like a, you can put a spike on your hand or something like that. So, this is a group tool. This, don't show this again, it's kind of broken, so it like never goes away. See if you open it. Well, it stays until you leave the game. So, I'll show you how to use a group tool here. So, let's say, you know, I have this part, but we don't want to hit non-collide because we don't want it to fall through the floor, but we also don't want this part to be colliding with it. See, if I go into battle mode, these two parts, you see they're colliding. We don't want that to happen, but we also don't want the part to fall through the floor. So, here's the thing we can do with that. We can go into group. We can view groups, you see. These are already set to blue, which if we go into assign groups, you can see click to select group. That's group one. So we'll just select group two, control click to select stuff, and control drag to make a block. So it's different from shift drag. Shift drag will not work, so control drag. And assign group to selection. As you can see that now we have grouped that. It says grouping complete. And you can see we have a blue and a red part there. So if we go into manage groups, this might be a little confusing, but you can see group two can collide. That means it can collide with the group one. So we'll just set that to false. So this is how you select the thing. So we're gonna say group one, run group one right now. So group two can't collide with it, group two. False. Alright, so you see what? Okay, hold on. I think I did that wrong. So we'll have these here, right? And then I'll group it. View groups, manage groups, okay. False, false, false. Okay, see that block just went inside the other one, but it's not falling through the floor. You see? These just do not collide with each other, but they can also collide with the map. So it's like selecting a certain, it's calling out a certain part to not collide with instead of just not colliding with anything at all. So that's pretty useful. You can make like a suspension with it or something. You put like your groups, like you want your tire, you want a fender, right? But your tire is not colliding with it, with the fender. So you don't want to set your fender to non-collide because, hey, I don't want my fender be non-collide, you know? Like your fender for your tire. So your tire bottoms out on it, so you just set the groups to different and then you make it non-collide for that selected group, and then the tire can go through the fender, but you, your person, or the map cannot go through the fender. So another thing to do here, so this is a bumper, it deletes stuff, you know, we said about that earlier. So if we group it, so if we see view groups, you see, they're at one. So we'll assign group two to this one. And you might have been wondering, okay, what's can damage do? So we'll set that to true, and we'll set that to true. And when this bumper falls on this part, it's gonna delete it, okay? See? Your own part can delete it. And then that's how that works, okay? So you can't actually kill yourself with spikes, you can only damage yourself with TNT and bumpers. So that's what that does. And go into saving here. load something. I'll show you moving the parts. So, group move this part, put it here, you know, battle mode. Well, it's still there. That's how that works. So, drag it on. You can see. So that works. Okay, so these are all of our parts here. I'll show you what they do. So these are just, you can build with these, you know. You can find more basic shapes in the, in here, which is actually gonna be called basic shapes. And then meshes, you see? We can find meshes, like a cone, which is, it's basically the same thing as a spike, but it won't kill anybody. And another thing you can do is, hey, I want to use this. Right, I want to use it for like a, let's say I'm building a house and I set it to grass and then I make it green. And then it kills somebody, but I don't want it to kill anybody, so you can go into your configure tool. You see, it says right there, configure tool. You can set the damage to 0. But if I set the damage to 10, that means somebody can step on this 10 times and it'll kill them. See? So it's basically like, if I set a spike to 50, it would take that person to get hit by that spike 2 times to die. And then, this air thruster, a water buoy. Basically what this does is it floats on a specific, axis. So, they don't have infinite force, which means that, it's not going to be, it's not going to float if you have something like really heavy on it, but I'll just set one like this. You can see that once this gets in the water there, it floats, yeah? So that's what a water buoy does. I showed you hover parts earlier, they just float at the specific height you set, camera. Aim parts, so an aim part is basically, I'll show you all three, what they can do. So an aim part. So if we point this up, you can see this red one, which is all, right? It follows my mouse. See, the green one only follows on this, goes horizontal, and then the purple one is vertical, so you can kind of see how that you can be used. See, the red one follows full, the green one's horizontal, and the purple one's vertical. So you can use that for like aiming your gun or something, or maybe you build a plane and you can fly your plane, but you can aim it with that. So a click door part is basically just something you can non-collide and then collide. An anchor. Oh yeah, so I forgot to mention, you can turn off anchors. So a click delete part is basically something that if you click it, right, it destroys itself, so you can drop bombs or somebody or something. You can keybind that. So these are lights, you know, you can turn them on and off. See? Turning the light on and off. It's a conveyor, so it's not actually just a conveyor. It can be used as a thrust, a conveyor, or both. So that means that this little, I'm gonna set it to thrust here. You see, it's not moving me. If I set it to conveyor, it moves me. And this is the set speed. So I'll set it to thrust, and then go to battle mode. You can see it moves around like that. Go back then. And then, this is an activator, so basically anything that touches this activator here, which I usually set them non-collide because it works better. So if I have, like, a click door part, and I'm going in battle mode, see that door part? It just hit the activator, it turned non-collide, and it fell through the map. So it activates stuff. You can use it to, like, you can put it on a motor. Oh yes, a motor. I forgot to tell you about that. So the motor, something you can spin a block on it. So we use the configure tool. We can set the speed, the torque. We can say it's clockwise, like, that's just basically the direction it spins, so we can set it to yes or no. And then locked in place basically means if you turn it off, right, so I'll spin the motor. If you turn locked in place on, it makes it harder to move around when you turn it off. But if it's not on, it makes it really easy to spin around when it's off. So it's basically like a friction thing. So this is TNT, we already said that those are weird. Pressure bombs, they move stuff. So if we have like a block next to a pressure bomb, and then we have, that will move that block. But the thing is that if you have something welded directly to your pressure bomb, it will not move it. And I explained this in the pressure bomb engine video. But you can see that it moves that block. So that's how that works. This is a trigger activator paired with a fuse. You can set the delay on a fuse, which means you can say, like, I want 60 seconds. I want this to be triggered in 60 seconds, and then I want this to be triggered in 10 seconds. And then we'll set a door part on both of these. So a trigger activator is basically an activator. Anything welded to it will get activated when the fuse is turned on. So I'll set this here. Trigger activators can also control fuses. So I'll set this to 0. And this will be facing this way. So once the fuse gets activated, right, we'll use red. So this gets activated, this gets activated, these get activated, but they have to wait. This one waits 60 seconds, this one waits 10 seconds. So let's say 10 seconds over, this one gets activated, then the door part gets activated, but we're still waiting for 60 seconds, that gets activated, and then the door part. So that's basically how that works. And then I'm just going to set the fuses to white so you can see where they are. So once I click on this fuse here, you can see it has a click detector. You can click on it, and now this will wait 10 seconds. Once 10 seconds is over, it will turn on that door part, or turn off, I meant. See that? Now this one is going to wait a minute. I'm not going to make you wait that long, but you can kind of, you know how that works. So there's just a few more meshes over here. There used to be a power shield here. We can get that from technology, and we go into like, where is it? Oh. Shield right here, so makes a sound. You can hear it, it goes, it's kind of annoying, but if you hover your mouse over it, says that. So you can use this to block people from destroying your bumpers or destroying your weapons or whatever you want. So if their bumper gets close to the shield right here and it gets inside this little ball here, the shield will just delete it, but it can only delete so much, so it has 100%. If someone brings a bumper in it, it deletes some of the power and it gets to like 90 or whatever. I don't know the exact number, but that's kind of how that works. So a stabilizer, we talked about this earlier in the starter map. I'll just turn it upside down. So that. And then it doesn't have infinite force, like I said, but it turns facing up. Cross. So this is a particle emitter, and basically you can set an image ID so you can get a decal. Right, I'm getting a decal right now. So I'm gonna go to decals, and then you can't see it right now because I'm doing it on my other screen, but I'm going to decals. If you don't know how to get a decal ID, you just go to create, library, and then decals, and you can click on the decal you want, and then you you copy the number, which is in the link, and then you can set it to that. So now we have this, and this is, okay, so I want this decal in blue. You see the blue decal. So we can say speed, you can set the speed faster, right? We can say the lifetime. This is like the the amount of time it goes before it gets deleted, so that's like 2 seconds. And the size, you can set that to 3. So now the size of that is bigger. And we can set the rate to like 1 or 20, and then we can set it to 1. You can see only one is coming out. And obviously there's a color there, so lock to part. So if we have that on, right, you can see I'm moving this around, it's moving the decal around. If we set that to off, it leaves them in the air, you see? So now it's like, I can draw a picture with it, kind of, I guess. And then the size, the acceleration, you can set that to like 100 or 30 in it. And you can see now it's going this way. So that's how that works. You can curve it, or you can curve it this way. Now it's doing that. We can do this. Now it's doing that, you know. It's just kind of like thing you can play around with to make it go the direction you want it to go. This is a trail part. It basically, it's just a trail, you see. I'm moving it around and it's making that trail. Can change the color of the actual part, which will change the color of the trail. You can turn it on and off, just like this and this can be turned off. So the little stabilizer, enemy, fall apart. This can be paired with a conveyor. And basically what this will do is this will find the nearest enemy, and you can put a weapon on it or something, and it'll go up to an enemy and it'll break their parts. But you have to be outside of your garage for it to work, because it's just how it works. So it's a texture part. You see, I have that decal from earlier in my clipboard. So I say studs for tile 1, and then that sets it to how many of those decals you want. So if I set it to like 5, now there's 5 every stud, or 5 every. I meant 1 decal every 5 studs, my bad. This is just a decal part, it's basically a texture part, but it's like this, see? So you can make like a really wide decal if you have it like that, you can make it tall. This will follow whatever is close to it, so it'll follow you or it'll follow enemy. Follow your pet, I'll show you what you can do with that. It just follows you, and you set that to like 10, and then you can kind of see it follows me around. So you can put like a, I don't know, you can make like a little floating thing that follows you around, whatever you want to do with that. Magnets, these will snap together, see. This red one here, if you set, click no on this, you see custom snap range. That means if this is in the vicinity of 5 studs, then it will teleport to this magnet. So we'll set that to 10 studs, and I'll set it way over here. So you'll see once that gets close to this, once it gets 10 studs, it'll just teleport to it, just like that. So go back to here and set no to that. So this is the range. Like if I had this over 250 studs away, it wouldn't come over and force 3500. You can set that to higher if your magnet isn't like moving, if you have something heavy on it. Sticky parts, like they stick to each other, you know, kind of self-explanatory. So you'll see that they're welded to each other now since they touched each other. And then this is a wheel. You can set the elasticity and the friction. The elasticity is like the bounciness, and then the friction is friction. So if I, you can see it's like really bouncy. If I unanchor there. So this is a passenger seat. It's just a seat, you know. Nothing special about it. You can sit in it. The driver's seat, we talked about that. Mech seat. You can see the mech seat is what we used on that mech. Basically, it just welds to your body, so you'll be walking around like this. And then a hover seat is like this. So a hover seat basically kind of stays in place. If I click, it goes down. So it stays at the same axis that it was put on by you. So there's a lot more parts in Insert. We'll go over a few useful ones. Like, I like to use anti-drones. Let's see, a whole bunch of people have drones. This will, like, go after drones. And you can put, like, bumpers on it. And then it'll just follow drones around and kill them. So that's what an anti-drone does. A drone decoy right here that makes drones go towards it instead of you. So you can, like, put them all over the map with bumpers on them and kill drones. Proximity trigger. You can set it to enemy, which means anybody but you. You can set it to only you, or you can set it to all, and it can activate, deactivate, or nothing. Both of those. So if we put like a door part, we set it to owner, and we set it to like distance 2. You can see that if I'm closer than distance, so if I'm closer than 2 studs, it'll deactivate. If I'm further than 2 studs, it'll activate it. So you can see that if I go closer, it should be turning this off. It might be a little broken right now. So, speed triggers, they basically, it's like the same function here, but if you go faster than 200 studs, it'll activate it. Slower than 200 studs, it'll deactivate it. You can, like, make a bomb or something explode if it goes too fast. Speed trigger, yeah, we already went over that. Height triggers, basically, if it goes higher than 200 studs, it'll turn it on. Lower than 200 studs, turns it off. Suit builder, right, I said earlier, like, you can attach a spike to your hand or something. You can go kill people. So let's make this color gray. That's our sword. Go in battle mode. You see, that's now we can go kill people. So a fuse. Yeah, we already went over that. A booster. Already went over that. Sound part. So it's basically you can get music. It's already set to the something. No, it's not. Okay, so we can get music, which I'm not going to play music because I don't know what's copyright or not. But we can put music inside the speaker just like a decal, which we can go to create library or library. And you can go to audio and you can click on a sound you want. And then you go into the link and then you copy the numbers put in the speaker. And basically you can turn looped on or looped off, which means that it'll keep playing or it'll stop playing after the song's over. A laser trigger, basically, if something is in front of it, like this, or like this, it'll turn it on. If we have a block, like, facing this way, it'll, you see, that laser trigger turn on that part, this one doesn't. But now it does, because that part's already away, so that's how that works. A speed indicator is basically like the thing on the driver's seat. You see, going every, I'll make it bigger so you can see it. So if I move it around, it goes, hold on, let me do this. See, now it's moving around and making speed. So that's how that works. Laser pointers, they're just like this. If I walk in front of it, hold on, let me go in battle mode. Put a part here. See, it turns green because it says there's a part there. And then it does that. So if there was an enemy part there, it'd turn orange, and if there was an enemy humanoid, which is like your player, they turn red. So impact triggers, basically if it hits something hard enough, it'll just turn on, you know, anything that's welded to it. Height trigger, yeah, or height indicator is basically like the speed thing, but you can see that it says 8 meters, 0 meters, zero is the stock height, so yeah, it's pretty much, you can probably figure out what proximity brakes and speed brakes do. This brake at the set speed is spraying. You can edit it by clicking the black part with the configure tool. You can say that I want to be like 10 length, 10 free length. You can show the coil or not, so you can hide the coil, and then see it's at 10 studs now. Still works like a spring, so that's what a spring does. Conveyor, sticky part, dead weight. A dead weight, you can set the weight of it. You see density 100. Just makes it heavier and not as heavy. Shoulder joints, basically what we had on the mech arms earlier, if you remember that. I'll put an aim part to just demonstrate on here. I'll put a full aim. So it can move in any direction, but they kind of snap together like magnets. See, when you go into battle mode, one side of the shoulder joint goes to the other one. So, remove mold, this is the delete part. Can have a wedge door or a cylinder door too. So, these are all the door parts that you can have. You can have a group delete, which is basically just a delete part with a circle around it, but I'll show you how that works. So, if you're in a battle mode and we click on one, well, it has to be key binded, but if you click on one, it deletes all of them, I guess. I haven't used it in a while. So, pressure plate, I'll put a door part on it. If you stand on it with your player model, it turns it off. You see that? So, if I get a movement mechanism, these are just the things you can get off of here. Decoratives, you can get those. I already went over those. So we have a few other things like gravity TNT and remote TNT. That's just a key bindable one. Gravity TNT will pull weapon items towards it when you set it off, but it has to be key binded, so I'll do that real quick. So set that to F, normal. And I forgot to go over in the thing, in the mech tool. So I'll do it in a second. You see it does that and then it sets it off. But no, not this part. So I forgot to go over it. I'm very sorry about that. So mech edit. Right, and then we have delayed normal and delayed opposite. So we set that. You can see you can set the delay time on it. So if I set like 2 seconds, and then we see this is door. Okay, I don't know what happened there, but basically what it does is when you hit the key, it delays it however many time. Like we can say like 3 seconds. See, if you hit the key, it'll wait 3 seconds and it'll fire it or whatever you want to do with it. That's basically just, you know, smoke, fire, right? That's what that is. Yeah, I think that pretty much covers everything. So, I'll see you later. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about the game, I'll probably answer it in the comments, like, hey, what does this part do? You forgot to explain that. I'll tell you what it does, you know. But yeah, that's pretty much the basics of this game. So, I'll be seeing you later. Goodbye.